David here. Today I'm going to talk about a couple different ways that you can send pricing over to your clients using your website. And so these tutorials are going to be based on Showit and WordPress. I'm going to walk through a couple options that you have in WordPress, and then I'm going to walk through a couple options that you have in Showit. So starting with WordPress here, and in this tutorial, I'm assuming that you have the Yoast SEO plugin installed. If you don't, I highly recommend it. But if you want to send a pricing PDF to a client and you just want to send it via link instead of via an attachment in an email, what you're going to do is you're going to come into media here. All right. So you'll log into WordPress, you'll come over to media, and then you'll just add your PDF here. Once you've done that, so I've already added mine here. All I'm going to do is click in here inside the attachment details. I'm going to come over here, and this is the link that I'm going to use. Now this link is pretty long. It's kind of ugly. I highly recommend running it through a link shortener if you're just going to send the link over to somebody. But if you want to make sure that Google, that this isn't going to show up in the Google search results or any search engine search results for that matter, what you're going to want to do is come down here to edit more details, select edit more details. It's going to bring you to the attachment page here. And you want to scroll down to the bottom to the Yoast plugin, select the advanced gear icon, and you just want to make sure that where it says Meta Robots Index, that it says no index. So this is especially true. You want to do this if by default your media is indexed. You just want to make sure that it's selected as no index. Now, if you want to send a pricing page to your clients using WordPress, what you could do is you just come over here to pages within WordPress, and you can create a password protected page. Now, if you have a Showit website, this won't work for you. There's a workaround. We're going to discuss that in another tutorial. But if you just have a WordPress website, this should work for you. You're just going to create a new page. And then over here where it says visibility, you just want to make sure that you select password protected. You want to put a password in here, select OK. And when you publish this page, for visitors to access it, they'll have to put in the password. And so you can design this page however you'd like. Now in Showit, you have a couple different options. First, let's discuss adding a pricing PDF and just being able to send that to clients. So same thing as you did in WordPress. You'll just come over here to your media library. You'll upload your pricing PDF. And when that's uploaded, when you hover over it, you're going to see a link icon in the top right-hand corner. Just select that, the link's copied, and then you can send that off to your client via email. Again, it's a long, ugly link. So I really recommend using something like Bitly to shorten that link if you're just sending the link over. And I discussed creating a branded short links in another tutorial. But with Showit, you don't have to worry about this stuff being indexed because, and I reached out to Showit just to verify this. So for now, none of this is crawled by search engines. So if you upload something here, it shouldn't show up in the Google search results. Now, right now, there's not a great way to create a password protected Showit page. There's a workaround for it, and like I said, we'll discuss that in another tutorial. But for right now, if you're not so worried about people landing on it that maybe you don't want to land on it, you can just create a page on your website. So we have this pricing page, and this is just a demo. This is actually our pricing page template, which is available in the Palm Shop. So if you just go to davianchrista.com/pricing page, you can check this out, and that way you don't have to go through the trouble of designing a pricing page. But we've added this to our website here. And if you just click into advanced settings in the right hand side, you can come down, just check this box, and it says ask Google to ignore this page. And when you check this, it will indicate to Google and other search engines not to index this page. So those are just a couple ways that you can make pricing available on your website for your clients.